I've really been lucky enough to be able to work with patients who had been told that they could never have children, and to be able to give the patients the hormone that they were missing in a physiologic manner and recreate totally normal cycles and allow them to conceive.
So this is the clinical research unit, which we use here to try to translate the insights that we gain from our basic research into human health. It is great to have a clinical research unit on campus because that allows our investigators the very close proximity to their patients.
Most people think about the reproductive system as all about the gonads and about estrogen and testosterone, but in fact the reproductive system is entirely dependent on what happens in the brain. So there can be abnormalities up at the level of the hypothalamus. So there may be a tumor that is getting in the way of those hormones being secreted. There may be some kind of an inflammatory process. Obviously, when you don't have, you know, anything that starts at the beginning, you really don't have anything that goes toward the end.
So what we do is we perform studies either on patients or on cells that we get from volunteers that come to the clinical research unit. And these people are usually very passionate about science, and they like to contribute to clinical research. So they come and they donate their time, and they're sometimes to give blood, and we can use that to test how the environment affects human health.
You know, people sort of say, well, what are you doing at NIEHS? What has the environment got to do with reproduction? And the answer is that the environment has a lot to do with reproduction. We don't totally understand all of the effects of endocrine disruptors, although in fact we know that there are chemicals in our environment that interfere with the hormonal system. But we also need to think about the environment as including other things like light, sleep, nutrition, energy balance. And there is a condition that is called hypothalamic amenorrhea that happens frequently in women who exercise a lot, particularly if they're of low weight. One of the things that I've always noticed about these patients is that there are some women who are incredibly tolerant to exercising and losing weight, and there are other women who stop cycling with very minimal decrease in energy intake or increase in exercise. And I've been really interested in trying to understand what that's about, because it helps us to be able to advise our women on what to do. In the particular study that we're doing, looking at hypothalamic amenorrhea, in our normal women, we're trying to figure out what might be biomarkers of risk for these individuals. Because NIEHS is located in Research Triangle Park in general, it's really important to have the resources right on campus. One of the things that is particularly helpful is really the capability of being able to be a little bit more nimble in the research that we do, to be able to follow leads, and to be able to take risks. And that's an important thing that really drives the field forward. And so I think that's an incredibly important part of what the intramural program offers.
Both the number of patients that we see and the complexity of the patients that we see has increased over time. So this is something that we always strive to improve and do more. But now we're getting more and more into very in-depth examinations of patients. We follow people longitudinally over time.
These are patients that I still hear from. I have patients whose children are now in their 20s, and I still get, you know, cards from them every year, letting me know how their kids are doing. It's pretty exciting and pretty fulfilling.